Rest assured, my eyebrow movement is actually a mild stroke, and this is Drinking Games.
This is Drinking Games, and I'm Chris.
And I'm Dan.
And Dan, do you know what game we have for us today?
I never read the script.
Well, we're going to be playing Burnout Revenge.
Now, is that when you don't wipe well enough and you get streaks in your underwear?
That is a skid mark, Dan. A completely different game.
Everyone loses in that game.
That's right. But today, Burnout Revenge, completely different, played on the Xbox 360 or PS3, doesn't really matter.
Well, that sounds nice on rice. What kind of rules do we have for Skid Mark Paradise?
Well, for Burnout Revenge here, we have some permit rules and some license rules. We'll get to the license rules later. Let's start with the permit rules. First permit rule we've got for you, every time you take out an opponent, you make them take a drink, which will happen quite a lot, mind you.
You know, what's really funny about this is, like, you know, games with gun violence like Grand Theft Auto, they get a lot of attention. Like, you know, why would people want to simulate killing like that? These racing games don't get that, even though I just slammed into, like, you know, a family of four in an SUV. They were just going to the zoo, you know?
They just wanted to see the monkeys.
Yeah, they just wanted to see the monkeys. And they don't get to see the monkeys or the chickens.
Every time you crash, you take a drink. But if you manage to take out your opponents with a detonation or an aftertouch, you make them take a drink.
Aw, man! Look at that!
How them apples taste?
They taste pretty bitter.
Granny Smith.
Kyle, if you can crash him, he has to drink.
He goes, go.
Yeah!
Oh, shit.
Finally, you will take drinks according to your placement at the end of a race. So, if you are first, you only take one drink. If you're second, you take two drinks. And if you're sixth, you're taking six drinks.
Delicious! Let's take a look at what it looks like on the field.
Finished! I finished that race.
Finished it in fourth place, Kyle. Take four drinks.
Four drinks. Okay.
That's two. This is the good one. Baker's dozen minus nine.
My adult diaper is filled to the brim with boredom. Let's move on to full license rules.
For our license rules, we have two variations that you can mix together. First, you're gonna need a partner for this. You, with the controller, will be facing the wall, completely opposite of the screen. Your partner will be looking at the screen, trying to relay directions to you, the player. This will involve lots of teamwork and probably lots of booze. The second variation of this rule allows you to actually be looking at the screen, but you have to balance a cell phone on your shoulder to your ear while you're playing. If you at all drop your cell phone, you have to pick it up. And remember, you're still playing off the permit rules as well. If this costs you a first place and you land in sixth, you still have to take six drinks.
As a bonus, on the other end of that cell phone is your friends, saying inappropriate things to you, right in your ear.
That's right.
Tell the man on the other line to take a drink, Kyle.
Take a drink, Buster!
Tell him to suck it, too.
Yeah, suck it! Or something.
Good job.
Yeah!
Ma'am, it's a missus you're talking to.
Oh, no.
Dan, what is the oldest cerebral game you can think of?
Well, that has to be Russian roulette.
That would be incorrect. We're going with chess.
In today's annals of gaming history.
Here we are, back in the roaring 20s. This time we're playing in 1220, and it's chess, a game played between two gentlemen. The rules are simple here. You just take a drink every time you lose a piece. Pawns are one drink. Other pieces are two drinks, except for queens and kings, who are three drinks. And if you ever use a term like en passant, you will be burned at the stake for being a witch!
No one's quite sure why Burnout needed revenge, but nevertheless, the game was made, so now that you're armed with tools for the weekend,
you can game responsibly. But don't drink and drive.
Unless you want us to make another ridiculous PSA.
And then I'll be sad and boring again. If that's what you want, I'll do it, damn it. I'll do it.
He will.